those beautiful slokas. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor for me to introduce Swamini Svatmavidyananda Ji to this wonderful audience. Swamini Ji is a great scholar of Advaita Vedanta and is a disciple of Pooja Sri Swami Dayananda Ji Saraswati, an internationally known Acharya of the Advaita Vedanta tradition, intermediate leader and classic author of Vedanta. Swamini Ji is widely in demand for lecture seminars both in the USA and internationally. She is known for her expertise in interreligious engagement, in-depth training, and scholarship on Advaita Vedanta and for the ease with which she unfolds the complicated subject matter for simple minds to understand and apply to daily life. And a rooted scholar, Swamini Ji addresses contemporary challenges facing the world, from global warming to religious social unrest, in her unfolding of Upanishads and the foundational spiritual texts of Hindu tradition. As a founding member of the Global Women's Peace Initiative, she has traveled globally addressing the ever-increasing challenges that face humanity in a global ethos. Swamini Ji is the Acharya of Arsha Vignana Gurukulam, which was founded in 2004 and has centers in Atlanta, Eugene, Oregon, Washington, D.C., Detroit, Milwaukee, and Fort Myers, Florida. It is with love, respect, and lots of reverence I would request Swamini Amma to give her message for us to lead a better life.
Kindness is universal. You know, once I saw one bumper sticker another by a student. And then, you know, the student who was driving said, "Did you see this sticker? Practice random acts of kindness." I said, "What other kind of kindness is there? Kindness has to be random. It is random." And so this is the, you know, this kind of a growth does not come automatically. It has to be initiated. One has to long for it, one has to make room for it in one's life, and it involves hard work, it involves a lot of sacrifice. Leading a dharmic life involves sacrifice. Learning to grow in this way also involves a lot of sacrifice, because one gives up things that are convenient, gives up things that are dear to oneself, and in this giving, there is growing. That is basically what it is. So if one has to grow into a compassionate person, into a person that, forget the rest of the world, into a person that one oneself respects, this is done only by what is in Sanskrit called, in the Shastra, known as Purta Karma. Purta Karma is this kind of a giving. Giving is not easy. It doesn't come easily. Because as soon as one thinks one would like to support a chhatralaya, one would like to support some kind of a medical, you know, clinic or a hospital somewhere, in an area where it is needed, immediately one starts to think of one's family, one's children, one's priorities, and there is a fear that comes, naturally. But if the fear is svabhavika, we are also given the means to overcome the fear. That is also given, that is also svabhavika. The Samaveda, you know, puts it beautifully. When it talks about this kind of a self-growth, there is a beautiful song. It says, Sedum Stara, Sedum Stara, Vista. Cross the bridge, Setum Star. What kind of a bridge? Dustaran Setum Star. Cross the bridge that is very, very difficult to cross. What is this bridge? It is this bridge of the second kind of growth. This bridge of self-growth, which requires patience, which requires Shraddha, which requires commitment, and above all, which requires some sacrifice. And this Kathantara Samadana, from which this excerpt that I have just shared with you is taken, makes it very, very simple. It says, this bridge which is difficult to cross, very easy to cross. How to cross this? How to cross anger? Akrodhena krodham stara. Cross anger by managing anger, by non-anger you cross anger. And then, and by not, you know, how do you cross no shraddha, no faith, no devotion? You cross ashraddha by cultivating shraddha. And then finally it says, Nani Naranam. Dalena Adanam Stara. Cross the inability to give by what? Giving. By practicing reckless, random giving. You know? And in conclusion, I will talk about a promise that is made in the Bhagavad Gita. In the Bhagavad Gita, there is just a lot of various kinds of verses. And some special verses are there, where Bhagavan directly promises Arjuna, and through Arjuna, all the devotees, a few things. Like one wonderful example is this, you know, Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya Glanir Bhagati Bharata, that is a famous one. Whenever there is a decline, neglect of Dharma, I will incarnate myself repeatedly in order to keep this Dharma intact, this Sanatana Dharma, in order to give karma phala to others, to violate his dharma. Like this, there is one more verse. This one is famous. Another one is also famous, coming right in the middle of the Bhagavad Gita, in the middle of the ninth chapter, which is in the middle of the Bhagavad Gita, where it says that, you know, Yoga Kshemam Vahami Aham. You know, I will take care of your needs and wants. And I will make sure that whatever you want, yoga means whatever you want, you don't have. Apraptasya prabalam, yoga. Praptasya rakshanam, kshema. What you have, you want to retain. What you don't have, you want to get. You don't worry about it. That's not your job anymore. For the one who is submitting to this growth, this is not your job anymore. It is my job. You just worry about your growth. You do what you need to do. I will make sure that your needs are taken care of. As long as you are, you know, ananyas chintayantoma yejanaha paryopasate tesham nityabhiyuktana yogakshemam vahami aham. I will take care of that as long as you are doing this, what is called ananya chintanam. Ananya chintanam is the study of the Bhagavad Gita and is the knowledge of the truth of the Lord as oneself. The truth of oneself is not separate from the Lord. Ananya chintanam is also looking at the whole jagat as the manifestation of Bhagavan, of Ishvara. So whoever one helps, it is Ishvara. Whatever one does is Ishvara. The ability to help is also Ishvara. The one who leads this life, Ishvarizing the universe. Is that such a word? Ishvarizing? Now it is. So Ishvarizing the universe. For them, all the needs, wants are taken care of. So with this, you know, this kind of a promise made not by some, you know, some person, Mr. Krishna. No, this is Bhagavan Uvacha, Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. And so this promise made by the Lord should give some, you know, should give us time to pause and think if any kind of fears about this giving, about supporting the movement where you can see, we have been seeing these videos of these flowers, beautiful flowers, fragrant flowers in the form of children and all their achievements. To support this is, as I said in the beginning, is a win-win situation. And I don't know who is the bigger winner. Is it them or is it you? Om Tat Sat.